going to work with this Audi Q7. The complaint is pretty straightforward. Check engine light without any complaints of drivability. So I'm going to hook up the back comm and we're going to see what error cuts we are getting from this engine ECU, and we're going to continue from there.
Okay, so let's check the... why we have a check engine light in this in the ECU. So no fault codes, but let's take in mind this is V8 TDI and this cars have two ECUs. So let's go in the other ECU, which is engine 2. Go hook. Okay, this is not going. This is not going to cost check engine light for sure. Go hook 5. And I believe this is our problem. Throttle valve 2. Yeah, we have a lot of trouble codes about this throttle body for sure. This is on bank 2, I believe. So throttle body, control circuit for throttle body, module 2, stuck or difficult to move, and malfunction, intermittent. So let's go to the engine bay and see what we're going to find out there. Okay, this is the two throttle bodies, the left and the right one. For bank 2, this is our throttle body which is making all the troubles. This is bank 1, which we don't have any fault codes. Now I'm going to show you what is the easiest way to check these throttle bodies. The quickest and the easiest way. So for that I'm going to remove them from their places and I'm going to show you what test we're going to perform. So the both throttle bodies are removed. We need an eye contact to them. We're going to watch them. Are they moving or not? Okay, so I'm going to get in the car and let's watch the throttle bodies. We can see we have plenty of movement on the left throttle body. Right now it's on the right, but doesn't matter, and no movement at all on the right one. So the easiest step to do to see for wiring integrity to the throttle body itself, it's pretty easy. There is some cool parts when you're working on V8. You just can swap some parts around and see what's going to happen. So I'm going to disconnect this throttle body. Like that. And the other one. And I'm just going to change their places. Pretty straightforward. And I'm going to redo the test with the ignition on and off and see are this throttle body is going to start to move or not. As we can see, the fault is moved with the throttle body. So now we have a working right throttle body and problem on the left one, just by swapping the forks around. So we confirmed that we have faulty throttle body on the right now on the left side, and with the magic of the video editing we have second hand unit right here, which now I'm going to place on this plug where we have a faulty throttle body, and we're going to see is it going to work or not as it should be. I'm going to leave it like that. So once again, I'm going to put ignition on and after that off to see is it going to move or not. As we can see, the both throttle bodies is working identically. So I believe this is going to fix this car. We're finally going to be able to clear the fault code and the check engine light. So now I'm going to reinstall the both throttle bodies and I'm going to do a test drive to see are we going to have some trouble. But I believe like BMWs, if you have a faulty throttle body, you are not going to be able to perform a regeneration on the DPF on this type of engines. So probably the car is going to go in the regeneration mode pretty soon after we start testing the car. But doesn't matter, this is not a big of a problem. So let me reinstall them and check once again the fault codes after a test drive. By doing all this swapping of the throttle bodies, we are confirming the wiring integrity and the control of the two ECUs which are controlling the throttle valves accurately. And now I'm going to do a test drive and we're going to see once again the fault codes. Previously this fault code was not able to be deleted, so now first I'm going to try to delete it and after that I'm going to do the test drive. Okay, once again, VCDS, let's go in engine 2, fault codes, once again the glove box, throttle piston intermittent, everything is intermittent. Let's see, are we going to be able to clear it, and no fault codes. I'm pretty sure that this is going to fix this car. Once again. So previously I was not able to clear these fault codes. Right now I am able and we literally saw that the throttle body was not working. So for sure this is going to fix this car and I'm going to end up this video here because I'm in a little bit of a rush. So thanks for watching guys and see you in the next video.